Hi guys, so my name's Gabby and I'm just going to be leading you through a short yoga flow as part of the Stay Well, Stay Home campaign. So I hope you're feeling good today. Don't worry if you've never done any yoga before, there's going to be some challenges in there, but I just want everybody, however you're feeling today, to take it at your own pace. And it's going to be online so you can go back to it and practice it as much as you like. And we will be doing new videos every week as well. So you don't need anything at all. If you have a mat, that's great, but you could also just do it on your floor at home, so we don't need any props. And yeah, we're just going to get started. So finding a spot where you can comfortably move, and we're going to just begin in a really comfortable position. So lying down, bring your heels to the edges of where your mat would be, and then just let your knees knock in together so there's some support there for the legs. Have a moment to let the back of your neck lengthen, the back of your shoulders to spread, and then just open the arms out nice and wide here into a T shape. So you can really feel the back of your body begin to connect with the space underneath. Before you close your eyes, take a moment now just to observe the space that you're in. So maybe you've spent a lot of time in this room recently. Can you take an opportunity now to look at this space with fresh eyes? So as if you've never seen the room before, and just notice 5 things that you can see. Be really explorative about that. There's no right or wrong, so just having a look around. Once you notice one thing, taking your attention to the next. And we're just creating a new memory for ourselves in this room. And as you look at the room, maybe you can feel into the energy of the space. So this place that's been protecting you, keeping you warm and safe for the past few weeks. Maybe you have a moment here of gratitude or thank you. A moment of dialogue with you and the space around. And then when you're ready, let the eyes gently, gently close. Waking up that sense of hearing and just beginning now to notice 4 things that you can hear. Maybe it's the music. Maybe you can hear some noise from outside or elsewhere in the home. So we're fine-tuning that sense of hearing. And as you have those 4 things, drop a little bit deeper in and start to see if you can become aware now of 3 things that you can feel. Now this could be on the outside layer of your body. So the texture of the ground underneath your skin, maybe the texture of your clothes, maybe you can feel the air moving against your skin. And if you go a little bit deeper in, maybe 3 things you can feel could be within how you're feeling emotionally today. And whatever the answer to that is right now, is absolutely okay. There is no right or wrong way to be at this time. And through our yoga practice, whatever you do feel within, we're just going to allow it to move. So feeling can be fluid, just like your breath. And then beginning just to notice that breath a little more now. So feeling into the air around your nose, can you pinpoint that moment when your air becomes breath? So when you take that air in and transform it into something that can fill you up with fresh energy. So every inhale can be an opportunity to revive your body and your mind. And every exhale, an opportunity to let go of something in the body or in the mind. down the eyes and invite a smile across your lips. Even if it doesn't feel easy to smile today, have a go at bringing this smile in. Allow it to rest there for a while and just notice any feeling that it can transform within your body. You're reminding yourself that you deserve to smile and feel joy just as part of your birthright. And you don't need any reason to smile because it simply feels good. So just now bring the hands to rest on your body with one hand resting on your belly, one hand resting at the center of your chest. And start to feel into the breath. So as you inhale, send the breath down into your belly. Keep breathing higher up into your lungs. Keep breathing higher up to the top palm on the chest. Let the chest lift. And then as you exhale, allow the chest to soften. The lungs to empty, ribcage drawing back together, and the belly to empty, navel dropping down. Very soft, easy breath. So as you inhale, sipping the breath in through the nose, sending it into your belly, breathing into the lungs, spreading the ribs, breathing all the way to lift the chest, the collarbones, and then exhaling bit by bit, all the way back down to the belly. So we're going to do this four more times to a lengthened breath. Inhaling. Four, three, two, one. Exhale. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale. Four, three, two, one. Exhale. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale. Four, three, two, one. Exhale. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Last one. Inhale. Four, three, two, one. Exhale. Six, five, four, three, two, and one. Hopefully feeling now that breath a little deeper. Inhaling to feel your whole body expand. And exhaling to let go of any tension in your body and let the body get heavier as you feel yourself supported by the ground underneath. If it feels useful to you right now, as you inhale, say to yourself in the mind, I have everything I need. Knowing that within yourself, you have everything that you need to feel good, to feel balanced. And as you exhale, letting go of any resistance to change, knowing that you can flow with whatever life brings your way next. Inhaling, I have everything I need. Exhaling, I let go of resistance to change. And then just bring your hands into prayer at the center of your chest. And we'll take one more deep breath into all of that. Inhaling in. Opening your mouth, exhaling as you release. Really nice, everybody. And then open your arms out into a T-shape once again. Lifting the knees up towards the ceiling, taking a deep breath in here. Exhale, let your knees tip across and over towards the right-hand side and just turn to look towards the left. Inhale to lift your knees up through the center. Exhale, let your knees tip over to the left as you turn to look towards the right. So just waking up the hips and the lower back. Inhale, lift the knees. Exhale, tip to the right, look to the left. Inhaling through centre. Exhale, tip and let your movement and your breath match together. Start to really hear the sound of your breathing, being soothed by that gentle sound. And then bring the knees back to center. We'll just find a gentle motion here for the lower back. So as you inhale, start to arch your spine so you're really gluing the lower back down in towards the mat, lifting the lower back. And then exhaling, tuck the pelvis back under so the lower back flattens into the ground. So a very small movement. Inhaling, pulling the lower back in as you arch the lower spine. Exhale, draw the belly in as you press the back down into the ground. And then bring the arms to the side of the body. We'll make this a little bit bigger. Inhale, push through your feet, reach the arms all the way overhead, open up through the front of the hips. Have a feeling of your knees traveling forwards and away. Exhale, roll your spine back down piece by piece and let the palms and the lower back land at the same time, releasing at the end. So the inhale pushes through your feet, reach the fingertips overhead, keeping the jaw relaxed. Exhale as you roll all the way back down to that start position. Do this once again, pressing into the feet, reaching the arms overhead. This time keep your body where it is, but interlace the fingers underneath, shuffle the shoulders under the body. So you can really let the chest open now, squeeze the little finger into the mat, and then inhale, if you can lift up a little bit higher. Exhale, relax your glutes a little, but keep the legs strong. Take one more deep breath in here. Exhale, let your arms softly release and roll the spine all the way back down, bit by bit. And then hug the knees in towards the chest, and then start to just let the knees roll out and then back in. So feel it into the front of the hips, the lower back, and whatever might be caught up in those hips today. And then bring the knees together at the center of the chest. Reach the arms overhead once again. Start to squeeze your lower back down into the ground as you engage through the belly. And inhale to lift the arms up, reach it back through your fingertips. As you exhale, can you reach the arms to the outside of that right leg? So we're hugging in through the core, squeezing through the inner thighs. Inhale, lift back overhead. Exhale, reach the arms over to that left-hand side, squeeze the inner thighs together. Inhale, lifting overhead, keep the chin lifted from the chest. Exhale, reaching over to that right-hand side, doing amazing. And again, inhale as you lift up. Exhale, reach the arms over to the left. Inhale, back through centre. Now for this final moment, can you kick those heels away? Keep squeezing the lower back down, drawing the belly in, and just hold it here for 5, 4. You've got it. Can you go a bit lower with the legs? Last 2. And 1. Amazing. Hug the knees into the chest. Start to gently rock and roll on your spine to build up some momentum. And then we'll lift all the way up and through a seat. And from your seat, just rolling all the way on to find a tabletop position here on your mat. Knees under the hips, spreading the palms, hands under the shoulders. Finding a cat-cow. So really spreading your fingers as much as you can. Inhale to lift up through your chest. Lift the tailbone up and let your collarbones open. Find a nice long neck. On your exhale, push the ground away with your hands. Let your head drop down and really lift up that space between your shoulders as you hug the belly in. Cat pose. So snake through your spine. Inhale, lift up through the chest. Exhale, curving through. Inhaling as you lift. Feel a sense of the belly stretching as you drive the hands in. Exhale, push the ground away, hug the belly in. And then coming all the way back through that tabletop, open your knees wide, send the tailbone back to the heels, finding a child's pose. So my knees are wide, my forehead is softening down to the ground. Let the forehead drop down and just roll your head gently from side to side. So you're softening into that head space, washing away any tension in the mind. And then find a bit of rolling action in your hips as well. Feeling into the hip space. A figure of eight action around the hips. And then bring your body back to stillness. As you inhale, lift the right arm up. Exhale, slide it through the gap under that left side. side and drop the right ear down to the mat. Can you keep actively pushing forwards and away through that left palm to really get the length all the way down your spine and push the ground away with the right arm. Breathe into the back of the shoulders. And then coming back into centre. Inhale, lift the left arm. Exhale, slide it under that right arm as you drop the left ear down into your twist. Both arms are active and strong. And can you pull back through the left side of the body a little bit more? Good, and then coming all the way back into child's pose. Okay, so from your child, start to lift the body up. We're gonna tuck the elbows into the side of the waist. Tuck the pelvis under. And start to lower all the way down, engaging through those triceps. And then push the ground away to lift yourself back up. Knees wide as you shift back to child. So inhale, roll you forwards. Elbows squeeze in, exhale, lower it down. Hug the elbows in, inhale to lift. And exhale, shift it back. Now either you stay with this variation or inhale, shift you forward. Maybe you tuck those toes, make it a full plank. And then you lower down. This is just an option, guys. Inhale, lifts back up, opening those knees, shifting back to child. We'll go one more time on your variation. Inhale as you lift. Exhale to lower, find that control. Inhale to lift. Knees wide, shifting back into child. Really good. Know that you can come back to child's pose whenever you need throughout this practice. It's always here. Gently start to tuck the toes under and lift up into your downward facing dog. So from down dog to start with, let's just find some softness in the knees as we spread the palms and push forwards and away. So we really want to get the length of the spine here. Chest pressing back towards the thighs. Let your head feel heavy, so give the neck a little shake out. Let the head release. And see if you can open up the tops of your shoulders. So get a feeling of your upper arms rolling outwards as you push down through your palms. Push through the thumb and the first fingertip. When you're ready, start to wake up the backs of your legs. So melt one heel into the mat and then the other. And check in with that breath again. Whenever you notice you're holding it, just gently start to even it out again. Inhaling and exhaling through your nose for an equal breath. So that inhale is our uplift of energy and the exhale is the grounding, and we need to find the balance between the two. Maybe you have a little twist side to side to feel into the space between your armpit and your hip, and just allow it to feel good moving and waking up your body here. And then from your downward facing dog, look to the top of your mat. Start to make your way forwards, walking the feet forwards, bit by bit by bit. Oh, never mind about that. So bringing your feet hip distance apart, soften the knees and hang in here in your rag doll. And just let the head dangle. Find a little bit of rhythm as you soften from side to side. Can you balloon the back of your body with your inhale? And exhale, let the arms release down towards the ground and then deepen the bend in your right knee. Place the right hand down and start to lift the left arm up as you inhale. Exhale, soften back through centre, bend the left knee. Inhale, reach the right arm up, gazing upwards. Exhale as you soften. Again, changing sides. Inhale, lift that left arm up. Maybe you come up onto the fingertips. Exhale, soften. Find that flow of your breath with the movement. Inhale, lift. Exhale, soften. And then coming through centre, soften the knees. Start to roll all the way up through the spine as you lift all the way up to the top. When you get to the top, roll your shoulders down and back, open the fingertips wide and bring the big toes to touch here. Find length down the back of your spine. Soften the shoulders away from the ears. Close your eyes for a moment and just feel into the strength within your body. So push into the outside edges of your feet. Pull up through the spine. Draw the lower ribs in and up. And find that soft smile in your face. A feeling of joy and enthusiasm in your body. It's all good. Gently opening the eyes. chest. Exhale, plant the hands and then step or hop all the way back into that plank pose. So kicking back through the heels, pushing the ground away with the hands. And then either knees or one stack as those elbows come in, you lower down. Roll the shoulders. Inhale, lift up to a cobra pose. Soften the glutes but press the tops of the feet down. Shoulders melting away from the ears. And then see if your hands can hover away from the mat as you really work on that back body engaging. Notice what happens with your face here. So can we keep the face relaxed and squeeze the elbows towards the waistline as the heart space lifts. One more deep breath. Exhale, plant your hands, tuck the toes, lifting up and back to your downward facing dog, hips go high. Take a nice deep breath here in down dog, breathing in through the nose. Let your mouth open as you sigh the breath all the way back out. Inhale to lift your right leg high. This is three-legged dog, high as you can through those right toes. On the exhale, draw the right knee all the way in towards your nose. Push the ground away with your hands and then lower that right foot to the top of the mat. Help it along if it didn't quite get there. And then from here, come up onto your fingertips. So can you kick back through that left heel a little bit more so the back leg is nice and long. And then inhale to open up through your chest. Let it lift. Exhale, lifting up and back. Let your head hang down and press that left hip forward as you pull the right hip in. So finding a place here where you start to wake up that stretch in the back of the right hamstring. Bend back into the knee. Inhale, lift up through your chest. Exhale, shifting back, let the head hang, press the left hip forwards. One more time, inhale, bends into the knee. Exhale, lifting up and back, press the left hip forwards, let the head drop. And then bend back into that knee, now push into your feet, engage the core, and start to rise all the way up, lifting up through those fingertips. High lunge. If there's any bend in that back knee, can you kick the left heel away to strengthen up through the leg? Inhale here. As you exhale, start to sweep the arms back and reach forward through the crown of the head. Again, inhale as you lift. Exhale, sweep the arms back, reach forward, crown of the head. One more time, inhale, lift. Exhale, sweep the arms back. This time, push into your right foot. Start to lift, 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 and see if that left leg can hover all the way into your warrior three. So the back heel is flexing away. You're reaching forward through the crown of the head. Reach back through those fingertips. Can you drop the left hip down just a touch? Really good, guys. And then bending back into that right knee. Start to bring this left knee all the way up towards the top of your mat. Good. So lifting that left knee up at the top. Can you fold the sole of that left foot to press into the right thigh? I'll open up so you can see to the side and we're in our tree pose. So push the sole of the foot into that thigh and then see if you can bring one hand to the center of the chest, maybe the other, melting those shoulders down and away. If this is really easy for you, find that next challenge. Maybe you close the eyes. And when you close the eyes, you have to trust that balance from within. So hugging the belly in, spreading through the sole of that right foot, and feeling those micro movements in the foot as the body does what it needs to do to keep you balanced here. One more deep breath wherever you are, keeping that focus. And then softly opening the eyes. Really good, guys. Bring that left knee back to the center of the chest. Inhale. We are going to tip all the way back through that warrior three as you kick the left heel away. Soften through the right knee, reach all the way back to come back up into your high lunge, reaching the arms up to the ceiling. Inhale. Exhale, lower your hands to the ground, step back to plank, and then move through that vinyasa. Elbows tuck in as you lower. Roll the shoulders back, inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, up and back to down dog, hips go high, soften the heels down. And just taking three breaths here in your down dog. You could equally drop into child, if that feels good for you. So just honouring the energy levels that you have right now, and this is always your place to just check in with that. One more deep breath wherever you are in down dog or child's pose. And then looking to the top of the mat, softening your legs, stepping or hopping the way all the way back to the top, feet together. Inhale to halfway lift. Exhale as you fall, let the head drop. Inhale, push through the feet as you rise all the way up. Exhale to release the arms. And then we'll go again. Inhale, lifting the arms up, gazing up. Exhale, release the arms, folding forwards. Inhale, halfway lift, find that length of your spine, open the chest. Exhale, plant the hands, step, or if you like, hop all the way back to your plank. And then either knees or one stack as you come all the way down. Rolling shoulders, inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, up and back to down dog. And melt those heels down at the bottom. Really good. Inhale, lift the left leg high, three-legged dog. Exhale, squeeze that knee forwards, forwards, forwards. See if your knee and nose can touch. Push the ground away and lower the left foot top of the mat. Settle into this lunge. Come up onto your fingertips. Inhale to lift up through your chest. Exhale, lift the bum as you straighten out through the legs. Let the neck relax, let the head hang. Inhale, bend into the knee. So find your flow here, open the chest. Exhale, lift the bum. Pull that left hip back in. One more time, inhale as you bend. Exhale as you lift. Inhale to bend into the knee. Now support into your feet as you rise those arms up into your lunge position. Good, hug the belly in. Inhale, reach up through the fingertips. Exhale, sweep the arms back, reach forward through the crown of the head. Inhale, as you lift, find that breath. Exhale, shift your arms back. One more time, breathe in with me, inhale to lift. Exhale, shift the arms back. Hug the belly and reach forward through the crown of your head. Tip onto that left foot and see if your right foot can begin to lift into your warrior three. Rather than collapsing down here, can you get a feeling of pulling up through your standing leg and flexing that right heel away. Drop the right hip down a little, soften the forehead. And then bending to both knees, hug the right knee all the way in towards your chest this time. Standing up nice and tall. And then see if we can bring the sole of that right foot to press into the left thigh, finding our tree pose again here. Pull up through the crown of the head. Lift the gaze of your eyes to eye level with a soft focus and see if those hands can come to prayer. Maybe you close the eyes again here and just feel into that energy of a tree. So trees don't ask for anything from anyone else and they don't need to be doing stuff all the time. They just are blossoming by themselves. So during this time, maybe you can find those pockets of moments just to be without needing to fill your time with extra bits and bobs. You're already doing your thing as you are. Your eyes are closed, start to gently open them. Hug that right knee back in towards the chest, inhale. Exhale, kick back through your right heel. Coming back through your warrior three with strong legs. Bend into that left knee, shift all the way back. And then reaching the arms up into your high lunge. Really good, take a deep breath in. Exhale, hands come to the ground, step into plank. And then moving through that vinyasa, so lowering the body down. Rolling the shoulders back, inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, up and back to your downward facing dog. From your downward facing dog, open up those knees, send the tailbone back to the heels, softening back into your child's pose. Melt the forehead down and just have a little roll gently side to side. And then from your child's pose, walk the hands in towards the knees as you lift yourself up and swing your legs around towards the front. So all we're going to do from here is take a nice, gentle forward fold as we start to wind things down. So softening your knees, wrap the arms around your thighs, drop the shoulders down away from the ears, and keeping your body compact to the legs, see if you can shuffle forwards just a little bit through those heels, keeping the body connected. This is not about getting those legs perfectly straight, you're just releasing into the lower back and feeling a bit of a stretch in the back of the legs. So drop the shoulders down. When you get as far as you can for now, let your head relax, really let it drop down. Especially when we're on our phones and laptops a lot at the moment, our neck kind of gets stuck in this halfway position. So can you let it drop back into its full extension there and let the neck relax. Come back to your easy breaths. Then maybe on your exhales, feeling that you can shuffle the heels forwards a little bit more, just ever so slightly, to get a bit deeper into that stretch as you soften into it. Take another breath here, dropping in, dropping inwards. And then start to roll your spine up. And from here, all we will do is come to lie down on the back, hugging your right knee in towards the chest, stretching the left leg long, opening up the space in that left side of the hip. Inhale as you draw the right knee in. Exhale, take that right knee over your body to the left and then reaching your right arm out to the side for a spinal twist. Can you open up that space between your right armpit and the right hip just with your deep breathing? And maybe you graze the floor with the right fingertips just to soften into that right shoulder. Let the body get heavy, heavy, heavy. Center, changing sides, hugging the left leg in, stretching that right leg long, shoulders dropping down heavy, taking a deep breath in here into the torso. Exhale, carry the knee over to the right hand side as you stretch the left arm over to the left, maybe the head turns to look that way too. Now we're opening up the space down the left side of the waistline with the breath. And maybe grazing the floor with those left fingertips now. And then bring the body all the way back onto your back. Have a moment here to just roll out those hips once again, evening them off. And then stretch your legs long as we come into our most important posture of Shavasana, our final rest. Heels to the edges of the mat, let your toes flop out to the side. I will work through a bit of tension and release here to let go of any tension that might still be in the body or the mind. As you inhale, scrunch up the palms into fists. Feel all of the muscles engage all the way up to the shoulders. Open your mouth, exhale, and allow all of that to release. Fingertips softly curling. And then feet. So inhale, scrunch up the toes, the feet, the calves, the thighs, the glutes. Open your mouth and release. Heavy, heavy, heavy. Inhale, scrunch up the muscles of the belly, the back of the body, as much as you can. Take an extra sip of breath in. Open the mouth. And then last of all, the muscles of the face. Make the angriest expression you can think of as you take the biggest breath in. Open the mouth and release. And let yourself just be here now. Just be here in stillness for a few moments to rest. Here and now. Reach down into your center, where the world is not spinning, and drink in this holy peace. Feel relief flood into every cell. Nothing to do, nothing to be, but what you are already. Let go of the way you thought life would unfold. The holding of plans, or dreams, or expectations. Let it all go. Save your strength to swim with the tide. Take this on faith. The mind may never find the explanations it seeks, but you will move forward nonetheless. Let go, and the wave's crest will carry you to unknown shores, beyond your wildest dreams or expectations. Let it all go and find the place of rest and peace and certain transformation. So start to just gently bring your awareness back into your body. Allow your breath to deepen. And invite some small movements back into the hands and the feet. And as your breath grows, when you feel ready to, take a nice long stretch and reach the arms all the way overhead. Stretch your legs forwards, take a big breath in. Exhale as you soften. And then draw the knees all the way in towards your chest. And just gently rock from side to side. Giving your body a hug and a thank you for all the amazing things it just did and all the amazing things that it does anyway, underneath the surface as well. And then rock yourself over to one side, press into your hands. Take a moment to just come up and sit and let the eyes be closed for this last moment of class, bringing your hands into prayer at the centre of your chest. Notice any feeling there in the body now. Maybe you tapped into that little bit of calm that is always resting there underneath layers of the mind. And whenever anything comes up for you this week, know that you can come back to this video or simply back to your breath to find that sense of grounding. Thank yourself for making time for you and your body today. And start to rub your palms together. Build up some heat and energy from within. And then place the palms over your face and just give yourself a massage. So softly rubbing into the temples, the jawline, your forehead, anywhere that needs a bit of waking up. And when you're ready, open your eyes. Namaste. Thank you very much, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the practice and I will see you again soon. Do get in touch with me if you've got any questions, and enjoy practicing and let yourself have some time to do nothing at the moment as well. Thanks very much.